So in today's video, we are going to discuss about inverters, inverter basic or introduction we are going to see in this video. Later on in the upcoming days, we'll be doing video sessions on single phase half bridge inverter, single phase full bridge inverter with R load, RL load. Likewise, we'll do all portions, that is all important portions of inverters. Okay, so this is the basic or the introduction video of inverter. Okay, so if you are seeing the channel for the first time, please do subscribe to it for all subject videos and also for job updates. Okay, so we'll be doing videos for the subjects, all important subjects like DSP, ITC, control system, analog communication, analog electronics, digital electronics. For all these subjects, separate playlists have been created, and also there is a separate playlist for daily job updates. Okay, so in this video we are going to discuss about the inverters. So an inverter means, inverter is a device which is used for producing an AC. We generally use inverters at our home, right? So what is it actually doing? It is actually converting DC to AC. Okay. In order to generate an AC waveform and an alternating current from DC, we use a inverter. So if somebody is asking you what is an inverter, this is the basic working of an inverter, which is converting of direct current to alternating current. Okay, let us see the basic things. Okay, the circuit which convert DC power to AC power at a desired output voltage and frequencies are called inverters. Okay, so it is the circuit which is converting DC to AC with a desired voltage and frequency. Okay, the inverter circuit's output voltage waveform can be square. This is very important. It can be square wave, it can be quasi square wave, means a little bit distorted or little bit square, little bit sine, that is called a quasi square wave. Okay, then or low distorted sine wave. It can be either of this. It can be square or low distorted square or quasi square wave or low distorted sine wave. Okay, now to control the output voltage of inverter, pulse width modulation techniques are generally used. Such inverters are called PWM inverters. Okay, so that is one type of inverters, PWM inverter. To control the output voltage, we go for pulse width modulation, and that type of inverters are called as pulse width modulation inverters. Now the classification of inverters are like based on the voltage sourcing and current sourcing. The inverters can be classified as voltage source inverters or current source inverters. Okay, now what is a voltage source inverter, what is a current source inverter? So when input DC voltage, so we are going to apply a DC, then we will get a AC as output, right? So the input DC voltage, when it remains constant, consider that we are going to apply constant DC voltage, then it is called a voltage source inverter, or it is also called as voltage fed inverter. Meaning, see here, you are going to apply a DC, right? And this DC voltage is going to be a constant value, means it is called voltage fed inverter or voltage source inverter. Now when input supply current is maintained as constant, if the supply current at the input side is maintained as constant, it is called current source inverter or current fed inverter. Okay, so these are the two types of inverter based on the voltage and current. Okay, sometimes the DC input voltage to the inverter is controlled to adjust the output. Such inverters are called variable DC link inverters. Okay, sometimes we give a variable DC input, and that is called variable DC link inverter. The inverter output may be single phase or three phase. That we will study later on by discussing single phase inverter, three phase inverter. We will do all those videos. Okay, so it can be single phase or three phase. Next, now based on the circuit connection, the inverters can be classified as half bridge, then full bridge is there, then inverter sender tap load, single phase bridge, three phase bridge. Okay, so these are the various types of inverters. Next, what are the various applications of inverters? Inverters can be used for standby aircraft power supply, high voltage DC transmission, variable frequency AC drives, induction heating, uninterrupted power supply for computer, and also for home appliances. We generally use nowadays mostly all homes, at all homes we have inverters, right? When the power is shut down, we have inverters at home, which will first charge. There is a mode called charging mode of the inverter. So we switch on the inverter and it will get charged. It will get charged to the full. And when the power supply is turned off, the inverter will give us the power. And inverter will give us what power? It will give us AC power. And that is how the home appliances will start to work. Even though the current has been shut by the current supply agency or current supply from the government, we'll have inverters at home, at our home, means we can have our appliances working. Now, for working of this home appliances, which device is producing the AC? The inverter at our home is producing the AC, right? So this process is called inverter operation. Okay, first it will charge, and for the charging it is actually taking a DC, that is, it is DC is being getting stored into it, then it will produce a AC. Okay, so this is how inverter is working. So this video was a very basic introduction video of inverters. Next, later on we'll do all various types of inverters, various loads, all those things we'll be uploading. Okay, so if you want the notes and the PPTs of this video, also subscribe to the Telegram channel. And also there is an Instagram page where I'll be posting all the job updates. Okay, so please do subscribe to that Instagram page, that is, please do follow on that Instagram page also. Okay, so that's it. Please do subscribe, like and share. Thanks for watching, and keep on watching.